May 26th, 2022. W. Ross McDonald School celebrates its 150th anniversary. January 1st, 2025. The Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act, AODA, comes into full effect. Businesses who fail to meet the AODA standards face steep fines. June 12, 2030. Doctors Burstyn, Gonder, and Lordanis of the IVI Institute cure congenital blindness. June 30, 2047. The W. Ross McDonald School for the Blind and Visually Impaired closes its doors as the final blind students graduate after 175 years of service. August 1st, 2089. Darian Masterson breaks the light speed barrier. March 5th, 2127. Dr. Melinda Talley's short-length time travel trial, a success. July 25th, 2131. First manned time travel mission successfully returns from 2130. December 13th, 2145. 9 cases of unexplained sudden sightlessness reported in Michigan State. Scientists uncertain if they are connected. January 3rd, 2146. Drastic uptick in reports of sudden acute sightlessness, both south through the states and north into Canada. Scientists still at a loss. April 14th, 2146. Worker shortage shuts down businesses. Health systems overwhelmed by the needs of the sightless. May 26th, 2022.
Get around in low light. But I thought you said this was a school for the blind.
I did, but technically it's a school for the blind and visually impaired.
So wait, not everything that read in your book, a blind school is actually blind?
Why does everyone think it's either perfect sight or perfect darkness? Just like everything else in life is Sorry, it's just that where do you come from? Blindness is totally new.
Did you say new? Did I hear you say when you come from?
Yeah, you see, we're really here 2146.
Blindness is a thing of the past, a COVID or false appeal. Well, until earlier this year.
You trying to box your own dangerous now? What makes 2022 so special?
Everyone knows from 2010 to 2030 was golden age of the disability. That will approximately decline 9 to 10 years from now, when the last baby born blind takes place in 2031, when they discovered their gift.
Without any more blind babies, there's no need for special people. And the last book of blind in Canada is shut down.
How does this feel?
As time goes by, more supports and funding are removed, but there is not necessary now if one has to worry about vision loss. That is,
is there a slow enough? A person there. Sound bang! Stuck blind, left and full of darkness. He's now managing 5 adult individuals who are completely dependent on their family for everything.
Blind people are not medically fragile. We don't require round clock care.
Well, guess you do. What if you have to go pee in the middle of the night?
Oh my god, speaking of water.
Amelia, with you and Ox going off campus, I'll have no way to reach you.
Oh, you know what?
door for the day if you want. I haven't programmed it yet, so Naya and Claire's number should still be in it.
Perfect.
Thanks. Satisfied, Elvis?
I suppose.
Great. Now that we've got that worked out, I gotta get moving. So if you're planning on coming, follow me.
Wait, Elvis, look, Cyclist girl is leading a second girl. No one would believe us at home if we told them about it, wouldn't they?
What are your kids still doing standing around here? Mario, please tell this young man I expect him to be of the bad behavior.
Oh,
honey, walk in there.
What did he say?
He said, we're always on our best behavior.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that, Sama. Off you go.
Get along.
Off you go!
I'm coming.
Good morning, W. Ross McDonald School. Opening exercise will begin in just a moment. Please stand for the national anthem and then be seated for your morning announcements.
Using all the skills we've been practicing in the last few weeks, the only thing you are not allowed to do is cheat by using a taxi or Uber to get back to school.
Got it.
Amelia, Ox, and I will follow behind you at a distance, but we will not provide assistance or interfere unless you are in danger.
Game on.
What's she doing? Why'd she just stand here?
Oh yeah, what are we gonna get this stronger world?
It's important before beginning to travel that she establishes her position and relationship to the surrounding environment.
Oh, I get it. So she has super hearing.
Not exactly. She does rely on her hearing to listen for where the most traffic's coming from, to see her bike, the lawnmower, etc. She can also use clues and landmarks to orient herself.
Oh, so that's what she's doing right now? Listening for clues and that other thing you said. Landmarks? I assume you're not talking about the ability to see the Brentford Water Tower off in the distance.
No, of course not, because that would be a visual landmark. A landmark can be a familiar object, smell, tactile thing, but it needs to be unique, constant, and permanent. The Brentford Water Tower meets all three of those criteria, but of course it's not accessible to her since she cannot even see it.
Yeah, of course.
Includes her things like which direction the sun is shining. It's not a constant, but if she knows what time of day it is, she can determine which direction she is facing.
Oh, don't look now, guys, but she's on the move.
That's great. It looks like she's established her hypothesis about where she is. Now she needs to approve or disprove of where she is and adjust her plan accordingly.
You know, I've met people who lost their vision later. They went from contributing members of society to some of them even having pretty impressive jobs. Like my aunt, who is a high-ranking member of the government. Since going blind, she's been stuck at home needing constant support and care.
Any amount of vision loss can be really tough to accept, but a major loss like you're describing can definitely be very devastating. They're grieving the loss of their vision, but also their independence. Imagine having to relearn everything they used to be able to do in life without thinking.
Yeah, I'm definitely starting to understand that now.
I can't can't imagine I could do that. And I still rely on my brother for car rides until I get my driver's license. And I can't even imagine having to trade in my freaking license for a dumb cane.
That's where Owen comes in. That's where.
What's she doing now? She's using her cane differently.
That's what we call sugar lighting. It's a help contain the street light travel. It helps fight intersecting sidewalks or street crossings.
Okay, but what happens when the sidewalk ends?
Then she would do what we call intersection analysis. It's a process of gathering information about the intersection, shape, size, control. For example, is a hallway crossing? Is it controlled by a traffic light? How much traffic is present? When can you cross?
I bet I can draw a line, but how could a blind person cross the road and not go into the middle of the intersection? That sounds really impossible.
I'll give it a try. I always carry an extra eye-shaded cane with me. This cane may not be the right height for you. And it definitely is not. It's very short and will not fit you.
Wait a minute, so you're telling me that these canes are unique to the user?
That's correct. A cane is measured by someone's height, stride, speed, or dashing time, stuff like that.
Oh, so I'd imagine the faster they walk or the longer their stride, the longer cane they would need because they would have less time to react?
Of course, that's correct. The difference between an inch or two can make a real difference. A cane, we also have different types of canes too. A cane I'm about to give Ox is a mobility cane. They also have support canes and identification canes. Claire is also using a mobility cane. We also have different types of cane tips for different purposes.
Fascinating. So how long do you say it would take someone to become an independent traveler?
It varies per individual on when they lost their vision, on how much owner instruction they can get, how much practice they can get, their motivation and need.
Well, how about for Claire?
Claire has had a lot of practice to get her to a place where she can problem solve and to get her to a place where she can travel on her own. But remember, it's not inspirational that blind people can walk. They just have to do it differently than us. That's why owning is very important.
That is not fair. I thought we weren't supposed to give her any assistance. Isn't that cheating?
Not at all. That's what we call soliciting aid. If this was truly the worst case scenario, then we would not be here to give her hints. If she can find someone, she can absolutely ask for assistance.
Okay, enough chit chat. Let's do this. Hand it over. Yeah.
Hey, Ox! Watch it!
Alright. How do I get onto the sidewalk?
We're just saying that!
Yeah! Can't see anything. I don't know where I am, and this thing's very annoying, and I don't like it.
I think that's kind of the point. Hey, Ox, try not to get frustrated. If you get lost in a story, I think the first thing we do is stop, take a breath, and try to reevaluate the situation.
That's right. Make sure you're on the sidewalk before you get started.
We've actually made it almost all the way back to school. Just a little bit further this way, and we should be there. Come on, follow me.
We'll be right back. Gregory, please sit down and take your seat, please.
Excuse me, Mr. Stafferton. Mr. Majuri said it was okay if my cousin Alice joined me in class today. Can he stay with me and Blake at our lab desk?
Of course he can join. Welcome, Alvis.
Thank you, sir.
I thought you said he couldn't speak English.
Are you okay, Blake? Of course I said that because I didn't want Mr. Majuri asking me a billion questions. And plus, Mr. Sowerman is too busy talking about the science and stuff to question anything.
Regis! Don't make me regret allowing your visitor to join us.
Sorry, sir.
As you all know, not only I am a science teacher, but I also love good science fiction. Did you know Mary Shelley Frankenstein is credited as being the first science fiction novel ever written? It was first published in the year 1818.
Oh boy, here we go.
Did you know what inspired Mary Shelley to write the story? A problem! A problem, Mr. Sowerman? You ask quizzically? Yes! You see, a number of years earlier, Louis Gavan discovered quite by accident that a spinal cord of frog carried any electric charger.
Yawn.
Gavan believed he found a proof of what he called any animal and internet force in a body's nerves. Wouldn't it be amazing to travel back in time and witness the new excitement of new senses discovery? But sadly, time travel is a thing of science fiction.
Good science fiction often predicts future scientific discoveries.
What's that, son? Speak up!
Oh, anyways, continue. Focus.
I was just saying, everyone knows about Bjørn Masterson, the first person to develop this, how to travel faster than the speed of light.
What? Well, that can be true. I just can't imagine time travel ever being humanly possible. On a particle level, perhaps, I just can't imagine time travel ever being humanly possible. I found that doubtful.
Humans might not be able to time travel, but in a few years.
Anyway, sir, it's probably just whatever. You continue on with your lecture, please. It's nothing. We gotta learn some science, right?
Yeah, that's our lesson.
Yeah. This is all fake time travel. What's time travel?
Well, as we talked about yesterday, today we'll be conducting our frog dissection.
Oh, yay.
Cool, I haven't seen a real frog before.
I'm trying to listen.
No.
Remember, guys, at any time you start feeling unwell during the frog dissection, be sure to let me know immediately as possible.
I can't imagine a frog simulation would turn anyone's stomach. We give these types of simulations to 4 and 5 year olds. I'm sure we know Jane is name.
Make sure you have your goggles, gloves, and lab coats on.
Someone takes this a little bit too seriously. What are we gonna need all those for?
Naya, I forgot to charge my laptop. Did you happen to bring yours or a charger for the lab right up?
You're kind of funny. When do I bring my laptop? Never!
To get the frog ready for dissection, press Rachel's side up to the dissection pit.
Really? You're using a real frog? Cool. I haven't seen a real frog before.
Press the leaves and spread out and pin them to the tree using your TK.
I guess I'll use my brailler.
What's happening?
It's a brailler?
What do you use it for?
For writing braille?
Okay.
Blind people use braille for reading.
It's basically a tactile representation of letters, punctuation, numbers, you know, all that stuff. And like blind people use it to read because it's like tactile. You know?
Cool. I'll definitely have to show Amelia about this later. I think she'll really be interested in it. Sorry, sir. Sorry.
As I was saying, one person will be carrying at a time. Remember, you always carry the weight from your body.
Did I hear you right? We're gonna be using scalpels? Or isn't he worried that you'll cut yourself?
Oh, we're not using scalpels.
We're using heavy duty scissors. I don't have to cut through bones with these things.
But what about the totally blind students? He's gonna hand out scalpels willy-nilly to the blind person in the room?
I said scissors. Heavy duty scissors.
Yeah. We're using scissors.
Are you a little slow?
Oh my god. I can start to smell the smell from the frog.
What's that smell?
Oh, it's the formaldehyde!
I don't feel so well.
Did he know they're visiting here all the way from Punjabi?
I hope you both are enjoying your visit so far.
Yeah, they're having a great time. But boy, are we ever hungry. We just got back from my drop-off simulation.
Oh.
All that walking sure can make a person hungry.
Oh, how did that go?
Piece of cake. Anyway, we really should be going. And hate if our lunch got cold.
Yes, of course. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. Mr. Sowerman, can I have a moment of your time?
Yes, of course, sir.
I was wondering if you could be able to tell more about...
Hey, sorry we're late. We just have to take Aldis to...
Oh, we heard all about it. Someone get in the middle of all of you.
Shut up. Hey, guys, got lunch here for you.
Oh, great. I'm starved. What's on the menu today?
Chicken, broccoli, and mac and cheese.
Awesome, I knew it! Ew, broccoli? There's no way I'm eating that. Gross! Ugh, I hate broccoli. I don't want it. Ugh, okay.
Here, Claire, your broccoli, your mac and cheese is at 12 o'clock, broccoli at 8 and chicken at 4.
Thanks, Mr. Wetstraw.
Oh, it looks like we have two extra amounts to do today. I'm going to work my magic and wrangle up an extra few meals from the kitchen.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks so much.
Oh, before you leave, sir, is it okay if, you know, my cousins here can join us for dinner back at London?
I don't think I'm gonna ride lunch. Everyone is contributing to meals for us weekly now.
Oh, yeah, that's not a problem.
For sure.
What does he mean by pasta's at 12 o'clock?
Oh, that's his most patient on my plate. You see how the mac and cheese is positioned at the top? That's 12 o'clock, just like on a clock.
Okay, so the broccoli would be at 8 if it's off to the right, and the chicken being to the left means it's at 8?
Pretty much, yeah.
Hey, boss, don't want anyone going on here on my watch.
Okay, I can pass them out for you, Mr. Wetstraw.
Would you like?
Of course. There you go.
Thank you so much for letting me stay after school.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime.
Okay, see you later.
All right, see ya.
Bye.
Have a good day, sir.
Thanks again.
So bye. Where are you got planned for after lunch?
Oh, I'm headed to yearbook.
Blake and I have gym.
Well, let me ask you something. What do they do in gym? Do they just do, like, run in place and then just do a couple push-ups? Is that what you do?
No. Actually, today we're playing goalball.
What
was that? Oh, it's like essentially every sport at once, but like none of them all. Does that make sense?
No, not really.
Okay, calm down. Like Seahawks in any sport, don't demand.
Okay, sure.
Let's do this.
But we wouldn't want to play. Are you really sure you want to participate?
I can beat you one hand behind my back and blindfolded.
Anyways, let's let these boys solve their fight on the court. You guys can go to gym with Blake and Claire, and Amelia, you're coming with me to yearbook.
Sounds good to me.
class? Amelia and I are going to yearbook.
No. The more the merrier. As long as your shoes don't stop up that jam phone.
Oh, we haven't had to worry about that since 2063.
What?
Oh, nothing. Their shoes should be fine.
Yeah.
Probably. Anyways, we'll move our trip with you guys later.
So they were playing volleyball. Have either of you heard of
it? No, not really.
Well, maybe it'll be mainstream. It's a highly competitive fun sport. It was first developed in 1946 as a way to rehabilitate soldiers who had become visually impaired during the World War II. It's even played in the Olympics. A number of our former students have actually done their school kids.
Now, Megan, seriously, it sounds really easy, especially since we're going to be playing against blind kids.
Oh, you know what? You can have one of these.
Yeah, no
worries.
Okay.
Actually, regardless of your student status, all the players have to wear an eye shield during all parts of the game.
Yeah, you can actually earn penalties if you're not wearing them properly.
Okay, if that's the case, then you can take this. I don't want it. Then you can count me out then.
What are you, scared of the dark? I thought you approved that. I guess I was wrong, but really, if we're blindfolded, then how are we supposed to play?
Well, all four of us are equipped with a knowing sight. All players have to listen to the ball in order to block with their body. But the best way to learn is by giving it a try, what do you say?
Maybe never.
I'll give it a try.
Okay, awesome.
Okay, this sport was developed specially for blind people, but you know they can't play real sports. Is that true or no?
Of course we can!
Well, most of the times, we just have to make a few modifications, but a lot of different sports can be accessible to blind people and low vision individuals.
Yeah, give me one.
Well, here at the school, we play vine soccer, volleyball, we also do cross country. Students participate in the annual soccer cup, cross country, biking, gymnastics, Richland's pretty huge. Students even enjoy shooting baskets at their lunch break.
Don't forget blind hockey and downhill skiing.
Huh?
Coach Hunter, we're waiting. Are you ready to start the
game? Yeah, on my way. I'm sure Claire and some of the other students can tell you more about it.
Yeah.
Downhill skiing? You've got to be kidding me!
Why?
Hurtling down an icy slope, blind, while there's other people skiing, that's so dangerous. And you're telling me that you're not getting regularly hurt doing that?
Just like any skier, you don't attempt the black diamond runs until you work your way up from the bunny slope. We also use guide skiers to make sure we don't run into people or trees.
Wait. Out.
It's important that we're quiet during gameplay so they can hear the ball.
Quietly. Play. I know. Penalty shots. Fight, please. Play. The ice is supposed to be worn over your eyes, not on your head.
Ouch. Come on.
try, could it?
I'll go in for you. You stay there.
Oh, Claire, are you ready to sub in?
Sure am, Coach. Thank you. Finally.
That was so much fun. I'm done anticipating where the ball is going to be thrown. I even managed to make a save.
That's awesome.
So, other than goalball, what are your favorites?
Oh, well, you know, goalball is my favorite, really. I'm hoping to make the junior national team this year, but maybe in a few years I might even be able to play at the Paralympics.
That actually seems pretty cool. How long have you been playing?
Well, I only really started this year, but my other sports, I really love running cross country.
So how does that work?
Well, I run with a guide runner, so if I miss anything, like a tree branch or a root, they just warned me of it.
And volleyball?
Well, with volleyball, it's a little bit different. We don't really play with a normal volleyball. We play with a massive beach ball filled up with quinoa.
That actually seems like a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun. You know, I'm so glad I finally decided to come here. I mean, at my old school, I wasn't able to play any sports, and I barely had any friends. And now, I have so many friends, and I was even asked to go to prom by a senior.
Sounds like a pretty typical high school experience.
Yeah, exactly.
Quiet, please. Play. Go. Okay, guys, I gave that shot.
That was so much fun. Apparently, somehow. I even managed to somehow score a goal. It was very hard, but it was fun. I didn't think it was going to be that good.
Wow, that's so awesome.
Thank you.
I'd like to game.
CDs are...
It's another audio cassette.
For a few years, we had our flash drives, but now, well, everything's online.
Flash drives? You know what, never mind. So I assume you get the teachers to record their classes and they send you the files?
Well, not exactly. Well, you see, most recordings, they don't have it in the classroom.
So what sorts of things do you record?
Well, a bit of everything happening in the school year. Dances, outdoor trips, a bit of lovely activities, and, well, pretty much anything that interests the kids.
So the students are in charge of the recording?
You bet. It's super easy nowadays that everyone's got a little microphones in their pockets.
She's talking about our smartphones. But then you must do the editing, because I imagine it's pretty complicated.
Haha, you're funny. The students wish. No, no. We make them do the work. I was audio file, because I have to listen through, carry the recordings, so that we've included the explanations.
You wouldn't believe the amount of audio pocket recordings I've had to listen to. So wait, let me get this straight. You do the recording, editing, and selecting of the whole yearbook by yourself?
Pretty much, yep. Well, why don't I leave you two to get to work? Now I can show you how it's done.
Alright, cool. Thanks, Mr. Gilson. So Naya, show me how it's done.
Sure, yeah. Okay, let me just find the last file I was...
Online 1990-2022.publication.rpb.housing3.rpb.housing3.rpb.online 1990-2022.housing3.rpb. I thought I left it open. I can't see it.
What was that?
What?
That voice?
Oh, you mean my screen reader? Yeah, so basically, by the end of the day, my eyes are pretty tired, so I like to use my keyboard and my screen reader, you know, navigate the computer. That's assuming if I can find my project.
So it just reads everything on the screen?
Sort of. That's if programmers take accessibility into account. Mr. Gilson?
Yes, Naya?
Can you help me?
Naya, how many times have I told you? You need to pay attention to which file path you're saving your work to. If you just put this under the folder labeled Naya, you should find it again.
Yes, miss. Oh my god.
Can you just help me already?
Alright, let me see.
I promise next time I won't do it.
Alright, let me see. Just try heading into recent files. Wait. I think that's it.
That's it, Kate.
That's it! Thank you, Mr. Gilson.
You're welcome.
What's all this I can see on the screen? Looks a little overwhelming, if I'm being honest.
Oh, that? Well, that's just Reaper. That's a fully accessible professional level dog. We've used it for some stuff around the otter, but if you use the fast end, then the electronic also produces some stuff in the software, too.
And students can use all this without being able to see?
Well, by the end of the course, for sure. Students usually come to the course doing the basic commands. The how to open programs, copy, paste, save, etc. Reaper has a bunch of unique commands, but once they learn them, then they're all set.
That's pretty cool.
It's honestly just listening and re-listening to the same piece over and over again until it sounds perfect.
Yeah,
honestly, that's how it is.
Yeah, that's kind of true.
I already imagine this technology would have other uses. Like someone with dyslexia can listen to a text instead of having to struggle to read it.
Well, that's true. So accessible end up being beneficial not only to the intended recipients, but other people can benefit from it too. But I know it's not really good one on population, but I love having a professional whenever I'm watching TV. Although I can hear it just fine.
And I always use the ramp instead of the stairs, and I always press the wheelchair button to open doors for me.
Yeah. Sounds about right. Well, that's last, ladies. Now you remember to save your work and pay attention to which path you're saving your work to this time.
Yes, miss.
Well, have a good night.
On the lottery, Jeffrey. On the lottery, to save.
Well, it was a pleasure meeting Amelia.
You too, Mr. Gilson. I really don't know why we're not using this technology in the future anymore.
I assume if you guys have the technology to create a whole time machine, you guys could probably reinvent or reinstate screen readers again.
Yeah, that's probably true.
We should probably check in with the others. Siri, call Claire.
Calling Claire, mobile.
Wait a minute. Did you guys use your voice to dial your phone?
You bet. I'll show you later. It's super easy.
Hey, we're already back at the house.
Okay, we'll be there in a sec. Bye.
tacos. We're using my family's secret recipe. We kept it under wraps for years. Get it? Get it? Under wraps.
What took you guys so long? I'm starving because of how late you guys are.
I tried to keep them off, hold them off, but the boys got hungry. Speaking of, you know what programmers do when they're hungry? They grab a megabyte. B-Y-T-E-Fight.
That's a good one, really.
Anyways, what are you guys doing over here?
Oh, we're making tacos. We're actually almost done.
I didn't get...
Since you guys were late, you guys are up on cleanup duty.
Seriously?
What am I not serious? Anyways, it's only fair.
Yeah, not a problem.
That is.
I didn't get to see a blind person use a knife in science class, but I guess we can see it now. First, you're gonna show me how to shoot desserts with an onion.
Once you've cut off the top and bottom of the onion and peeled away the paper skin, you place one of the cut ends of the onion on the cutting board so the onion does not roll.
With you so far.
Then, if you have not holding the knife, I form an arch over top of the onion and slide the knife under my fingers and slice down, cutting the onion in half.
And then you just repeat the cut?
Yep, until it's too small to pull easily. Then, I just put my hand on the back of the knife and chop! Ta-da!
It seems like we got the bed taken care of. What's left? Oh, the cheese.
Cheese! I love me some grilled cheese!
Why don't you grill
cheese? Sure! So wait, do you have like a special tool for that?
Well, at home, I use a food processor, but here at school, I just use a regular old cheese grater.
Nice! So, how do you not slice up those fingers of yours?
I just have to pay attention to where I'm grating it. You know, I have to be really cautious on how close my fingers get to the plate. And once it gets too small, I stop grating.
What about the rest?
You eat it.
160 degrees Fahrenheit.
What was that?
My coffee thermometer. It was coffee thermometer. After all, can't trust tacos.
Why not?
Because they spilled the beans.
Who puts beans on their tacos?
Gross! All right, dig in.
Maybe. Someone pass me the sour cream.
It's right there.
Where?
Stop joking, it's right there.
Thomas, are you okay?
I can't see. Did someone turn off the lights? It's kind of hard to see in here.
No, we didn't.
Thank you.
Hey ladies, are the dishes coming along?
Yeah, fine.
Alright, I'm gonna make myself some popcorn. Would you guys like any?
Oh no thanks. I'm still stuck for dinner.
Alright, suit yourselves.
Thank you.
second ago you were doing just fine, and then, oh, look at you.
Why? I don't know, I just couldn't see.
Alright, I think it's only a little further.
Whoa, Emilio, watch where you're going. Since I can't.
I'm trying, but I can barely see the path.
Hey, Emilio, what are you doing now?
I'm not sure. I can't see the path anymore.
Well, don't look at me. I don't know where I am, and I can't see anything. And I can't even get us there.
I don't think I can see anything either.
Great. Just very much great. They said they'd come with us to the path, they said. It would be fun, they said. Nothing could go wrong, they said. And look at us.
Nobody told you to come. But anyway, I have an idea. You can still see, can't you?
Nope. I am practically blind because apparently I don't have my senses. You know that.
Alright, well, I have another idea. Do you have that phone that Blake gave me?
I think so. Give me a second. Yeah, I got it.
Alright, hand it to me. Call Naya?
Calling Naya? Mobile.
Thank you. May 27th, 2146. May 27th, 2146. Children of Dr. Tully, inventor of time travel, return from the past with hope for the sightless. August 24th, 2146. 1 month with no new cases of sightlessness reported. Approximately 60% of the population has now been affected. October 17th, 2146. Government greenlights $1 trillion project to implement new support for the sightless. September 1st, 2147. Schools for the sightless open in every province, including rehabilitation centers for sightless adults. February 24th, 2151. Leading tech companies to launch highly anticipated open source screen reader software. May 12th, 2152. Driverless cars become the norm thanks to Tesla's new affordability line. March 18th, 2166. Golden Labs, thanks in part to their use as guide dogs, declared Canada's new national animal. January 14th, 2179. First completely sightless-led mission touches down on Mars. February 16th, 2188. 10-second commercial during the Goalball Super League playoffs goes for a whopping $50 trillion. November 4th, 2200. Hadley Spencer, first sightless woman, elected President of the United States.